Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome to the channel. My name is Jason. Today is Sunday, and it's hotter than heck here in Washington. We were just having one of those heat spells. Hope you're cool wherever you're at. Anyway, today we're going to talk about this Rocky Patel White Label, and this is a cigar that's been sitting in my humidor for probably, about 3 or 4 months, and I've been wanting to do a review on this cigar for a minute, so I thought today would be a good day. I got a little bit of coffee with me, and I want to get the cigar lit up, cut up, and then we'll get into smoking it. Let me pull it out of the wrapper first so y'all can see what's going on. The Rocky Patel makes the bands on these cigars are absolutely wonderful. I know some people out there don't really care about the bands on the cigars. I do, because a lot of these cigar bands are just works of art, and theirs is no exception. I'll show you guys the band right here. It's got the white band wrapped around it. It says White Label on there, and the kind of the gold embossed logo on there. It's got the ribbon around the bottom of the cigar, and I just think it's just a really classy look for these cigars. So let me go ahead and get it cut up, and then we'll start smoking this bad boy. So a little bit of background. So I met Rocky Patel for the first time when I was working at Napa Cigars, I guess about a year ago, actually right before I left and ended up having to move out of state. And he talked to me for quite a while, came walking in with some of his people that he had with him, and spent a lot of time talking to me. We talked about cigars, we talked about the cigar business. He spent probably a couple hours there, and it was a great time for everybody that was there. People were walking in the store recognizing who he was, and he was signing boxes and taking pictures with people. A really, really down-to-earth guy. Like I said, I'd never met him before. That was the first time, and I've been into cigars for a really long time. Just a really, really down-to-earth guy. So let me go ahead and get this cut up. I use my Calibri cutter today. I'll go ahead and get this bad boy cut up, and then let me get it lit up. Now hopefully my lighter works today. Every time I make a YouTube video, for whatever reason, my cigar lighters always run, and I fill them up before I start. So let's go ahead and get, actually this one's working today, this is the good thing. So let me get this lit up, and then smells great already. Connecticut wrapped cigars, some people like them, some people don't. For me, I enjoy Connecticut wrapped cigars. I'm not, when it comes to smoking cigars, I'm not a heavy cigar person. I don't like strong cigars, and I've made that known on my videos before. Everybody at Napa Cigars knows I don't like strong cigars. It's just something I don't like. Not that I haven't smoked them before, I have. I just don't like the feeling you get from smoking a strong cigar. All right, so here we go. Right away, a nice draw on the cigar, and then get up a little more. Get it lit up a little more here. Great smoke output. A little bit of earthy notes right there, some hay, a little bit of molasses, some brown sugar. Great start already. Look at the smoke output coming off there. As you can see, as I'm taking puffs off this cigar. So far, so good. So let me get a few minutes into the cigar, and I'll come back and I'll tell you where I'm at. I do have a feeling, though, I'm gonna have to take the band off at some point. It'll start getting hot as I'm getting closer to that. But again, I love the band. I think it's really, really cool. So anyway, let me get into the cigar. We'll come back and I'll tell you where I'm at and tell you what flavors I'm getting. All right, folks, I'm back a few minutes into the cigar. So I wanted to show you something real quick. Look at the crisp burn line on that right there. No touch-ups at all so far. I'm a few minutes in. I don't know, 3, 4, maybe 5 minutes in. And the flavors are remaining kind of where I was at in the beginning, especially on the retrohale, getting that, you know, little bit of molasses, that little bit of brown sugar on there, those earthy notes. A little bit of hay there. I really like where this cigar is going so far, and again, I'm pairing it with coffee, and the coffee I have today, I just have a little bit of cream in it, which I find, in my opinion, works great with Connecticut wrappered cigars, and it's just so far so good. Really good draw, again, really good burn line. So let me get up a little bit closer to the band right there, and then I'll have to remove the band obviously as I'm getting further up, and then I'll let you know where I'm at. All right, folks, I'm back. As you can see, I took the label off of the cigar, and I was trying to take an Instagram picture, and I had the cigar setting on the table. The wind kind of kicked up here a little bit. It blew the cigar off, and now the wrapper is kind of cracking in the other side, but it's not affecting the smoking experience at all. So far, so good. Still getting those notes that I was describing before. Now a little bit of white pepper has kicked in on the retrohale, and I'm getting a little bit more of the molasses in there, a little bit more cashew now. Some peanuts have showed up now, and I'm about halfway, I guess, through the cigar, and it's so far so good. I would say it's about a medium, mild to medium-ish, somewhere in between there, and really, really good. So if you're like a new cigar smoker, this is something you could certainly enjoy. It's not overpowering at all. The flavors are really good. You should be able to pick those notes up that I've been describing, especially if you do a retrohale. If you don't know what a retrohale is, basically you're blowing the smoke through your nose. that actually allows you to pick up more of the flavors of the cigar. Anyway, here's where I'm at right here. Like I said, I guess I'm about probably about 30-ish minutes in, maybe 35 minutes in. Not burning fast at all. Actually, it's actually burning perfectly in my opinion. So let me get down a little bit closer to the end right there, and we'll kind of summarize up where I'm at, and then we'll go from there. All right, folks, I'm back real quickly. I wanted to mention something that I forgot to mention before as I'm doing this YouTube video. So a couple months ago, YouTube had pulled my channel down. This was like the second time it happened. It happened, I think, maybe a year ago. So they pulled it down again and then sent me a letter stating that I was promoting tobacco products. And I'd already been through this with them. And then what happened was I appealed it, and then the channel came back up, and then it went down again. It was insane. Anyway, I got a letter stating that I was, or email stating that I was in good standing and blah, blah, blah. So anyway, but the point I was trying to make with this is that I wanted to thank all of you out there who have subscribed to my channel over the past probably, I guess, about month and a half, maybe 2 months. My channel was stuck at like 300 subscribers for the longest time, and then all of a sudden, boom, within a month and a half, maybe 2 months, I got like 100 subscribers, and it's just really kind of just increased from there. And I just wanted to thank everybody for spending your time with me and trusting my opinion on cigars that I'm smoking. You've seen a lot of short videos that I've done. A lot of people have commented on those and sent me emails and went to my Instagram page and have sent me messages on there, you know, thanking me for, you know, posting those cigars, and they went out and purchased those because of that. I just wanted to thank you guys. I really do appreciate that. So all the 505 subscribers I have now, thank you guys very much for subscribing. Anyway, let me get more into the cigar, and we'll come back and we'll see where we're at. All right, folks, I am back, and I am probably about 50 minutes into the cigar, and I'll tell you what, me dropping that cigar on the ground when I was trying to take my Instagram picture did the cigar no justice. It's just kind of, it kind of just fell apart on me, and that's, again, that's nothing to do with the cigar. That was my own error, and I've dropped cigars before when I was trying to take pictures of them, and the same thing happens every time, especially if the wrapper cracks. And again, it's nothing that has to do with the cigar itself. It has to do with me being an idiot and setting it on something that I shouldn't have set it on and trying to take a picture of it. Anyway, let me talk about the last bit of the cigar that I was into. There we go. A little bit better. Anyway, as I was getting down more into the cigar towards the end, a lot of new flavors that's showing up. I started tasting, like, interestingly enough, a little bit of cinnamon oatmeal. I got more of the cashew in there. Some grassy, like fresh-cut grass notes were in there. A lot of really, really interesting flavors in the cigar. The wrapper on this is amazing. I love lighter cigars like this. Again, mild to medium a cigar. It went really well with coffee. And the burn stayed consistent throughout the cigar. And I used a V-cut on this. Not that it matters, you use your preference, but I tend to use a V-cut on most of the cigars that I smoke. Really, really good overall enjoyable experience. And again, for transparency, I purchased a cigar on my own. It wasn't sent to me by anybody. This was a cigar that I bought. So if you're interested in this Rocky Patel white label cigar, and you like the flavors that I was subscribing to you, or describing to you, go out and purchase one for yourself and smoke the cigar. Again, have it with some coffee. Let me know what your thoughts are on it. Comment on the bottom of my page down there. Let me know if you've smoked this cigar before, because again, I thought it was enjoyable. Again, mild to medium, and the flavors in here were very good. So anyway, if you have any questions, again, leave them in the comment section down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe to my channel. There are more reviews coming, and I will see you in the next one. Take care, folks.